This week, we're fishing Kokanee Power Derbies on Oregon's Odell Lake for Kokanee and Diamond Lake for trout. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Oregon has several great Kokanee lakes, and one of the best, if not the best, is Odell Lake, east of Eugene in the Cascade Range. Shelter Cove Resort has long been a favorite place for anglers to call home at Odell, and today it's home to a Kokanee Power of Oregon Derby. Kokanee Power Derbies are competitive, but they're also set up to include kids. Greg Graham, the club's president, has three kids fishing in the junior division with him today, and they're all having fun taking turns catching kokanee.
Put that rod up. There you go.
This is a big one. Man, this thing is like wild.
Whoa,
that is a huge thing.
There will be prizes for all the kids, but the real prize is being able to spend the day on the water catching fish after fish.
That looks like a big one.
Reel. Keep your rod tip up. There you go.
Worn him out. Good job.
Brandon?
Whoa, that's a big one. Everybody gets a turn to reel in a fish.
And that's one great thing about kokanee fishing, and Odell has plenty for everyone, including Gary Miralles.
Well, the sun just barely coming up, and we almost got half a limit already. Been a pretty good morning. That's a decent fish. Good fish, Kevin.
Gary is fishing this Kokanee Power Derby with Kevin Brownlee and his wife Debbie.
Fish.
And so far, they've had lots of hookups. So now it's a matter of finding the bigger fish.
Let's get about four more of them. So take your time. There we go. Bring it up. What's biting you now? There we go. Good job. Well, that was quick.
Yeah.
I didn't even have time to get the other one back in the water. Wow, look at this guy roll. Man, I tell you what, you're glad you got those double hooks. Now that's that hoochie. I just changed over to that splatterback orange, and boy, it got hit pretty quick.
Yeah, it did. Double hooked.
Yeah, that's the thing. When you're out fishing kokanee tournaments, the thing you want to do is when you're not catching fish for a while and you're marking the fish like they are out here, you want to change up. And just a simple change, it might be the same lure, but just go to another color, and next thing you know, you're catching fish again. That's a decent fish. Another one in the box. Good job. Bring it right up the back here. All right, that's a good fish. Oh, yeah. Hit that UV humdinger.
Thank you. It was fun.
Boy, I tell you, we're going through some big numbers of fish in here, and it's like every time we pass through them, we're getting hit. This been running that about that depth, about 78 feet, has been the spot. Need a little longer handle on that net. Odell Lake is just a neat place. I tell you, staying up there at Shelter Cove, what a great facility to have an event like this.
And a great place for a barbecue. And I've always said the best part of a Kokanee Power Derby was the barbecue lunch, and today it's brisket and hot dogs.
And a pot of beans cooking. A bunch of potato chips.
Up to this point, we had 3.98 pounds. Guess what? You're the leaders. You got 4.01 pounds. There it is. Good job.
And with that weight, Gary Coe and Ron Walker take first place in today's derby.
Wrestling blade, UV,
Probably the best lure of the day was a pink pearl R&K hoochie. We also used several homemade spinners. Had a pretty good day. Most of the fish were running around 60, 70 feet. Very cooperative.
How many fish did you get?
I believe we had 37, 38 fish in the boat today.
Up next, we're with Gary Coe and Ron Walker on Diamond Lake for another Kokanee Power of Oregon Derby. There are no kokanee in Diamond Lake, but it is a top-rated Oregon trout fishery, and this weekend it hosts a Kokanee Power of Oregon
Trout
Derby.
Let me have the forceps. I want to release this fish.
We're with Gary Coe, who's won more Kokanee Power Derbies than anyone, and Ron Walker, who's no stranger to success as well. Diamond Lake is extremely rich in nutrients, which is obvious when you take a look at the fish.
This is an example of a fish in this lake that's less than a year old. That grows that much from fingerling size in a matter of months. Because of the food source. I had a conversation with the ODFW biologist recently talking about this lake. The interesting thing is that there's a strain of shrimp in the lake that does not go dormant in the summertime, in the wintertime, when the lake freezes over. Consequently, the fish have adequate food sources throughout the year. During thaw out, they've grown all winter long, but they're not hungry like a typical winter fish or spring fish would be because they've been eating, and consequently they're a little tougher for us to catch, but they're in great shape. Fun, nice fish.
This is the second day of the Kokanee Power's two-day trout derby, which started off with a red hot bite, so stuff is starting to wear out.
Broken net. That's a nice two-year-old rainbow, probably a pound and a quarter, caught on a flea bitty from Shasta tackle. I'm running this rod at 6 feet in depth because we're dealing with 60 degree water, and these fish tend to stay up, at least some of them, near the surface all day long. We're running other rods down to 25 and 30 feet, 5, 7, 8 foot increments, running from the surface down to 30 throughout the day, and picking up fish, typically, on all four rods. Here's another nice Diamond Lake rainbow. Isn't that a pretty fish? You know, I'm thinking that we just picked up 3 or 4 beautiful rainbows in the last 15 or 20 minutes. And we just passed through this same water an hour ago, going into the sun with no bites. We came back through with the same gear at the same speed and the same depth, going away from the sun, and caught 4 fish in 20 minutes. Makes me think that the sun has something to do with the bite. Look at this. This is an example of the food that's available in this lake for the fish. We've been trolling this sling blade and crip lure for probably 20 minutes, and there are probably 20 or 30 small leeches already attached to it. This is what these fish can eat all year round, and that's the reason they're so big and beautiful like they are. However, it sometimes makes it a little tough to catch because they're not real hungry. Little F4 flatfish with a little Procure gel on it. See the sling blade? Aha! Broken net and all. I typically try to grab my fish with a towel as opposed to bare hands. They excrete a panic enzyme that I just assume not get on my terminal tackle. I don't know if it helps. It helps me.
Earlier that morning, Gary Miralles of Shasta Tackle Company, who's fishing with Mike Elster, who runs Mike's fishing guide service, decided to look for bigger trout in close to shore before heading out to deeper
water. We're running everything top line in here, so what we're going to do, we're going to get back behind the boat, 150 on the center line. It's a diving crankbait. That'll keep it below the 2 outside rods, and we got 2 right on the surface. Crip will drop down maybe 4 feet. The humdinger on the other side, it's an 1/8 ounce, real light, not going to be any more than about 2 feet below. We run that on the inside of the shore. That's going to be the shallower side. So we picked up some nice fish in here at last year's derby on pre-fishing day, and hopefully we can hit a big one this morning.
Well, I figured that orange crippler had to get something sooner or later.
Gone?
Nah, it's just a little guy, I think.
It doesn't look like this year the bigger fish are along this bank, but there is no doubt that Diamond Lake is stuffed with quality rainbows.
This lake years ago was in bad shape. It had a lot of tui chub in it, too many that the fish weren't actually able to do well in here. So they poisoned it and have since replanted it, and this fishery has really come back. And the neat thing about this particular lake, not only is it one of the prettiest lakes in Oregon, it's also one of the best fisheries. And when we're talking trout, I don't believe there's a better lake out there than this one.
Welcome back to Diamond Lake. I'm Justin Wolf. It's the second day of a two-day Kokanee Power of Oregon Trout Derby, and so far it's been one of those red-hot fights where you have to sift through the smaller fish.
Yeah, normally I wouldn't let a fish go first thing in the morning in the tournament, but we caught so many of those things yesterday, I don't think we're going to have any problem today.
We got bumped several times, and just those small fish are hanging out on the shoreline, so now we're going to go out and fish some deeper water, get into 30 to 45 foot range and fish in 25 to 35 foot depths. So that's where we were picking up the bigger fish yesterday.
I was running some anchovy yesterday and they liked that for some reason, so I'll go back to that again. How's it feel?
Feels good. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, looks good. Oh yeah. Oh shoot, stay on. That's a nice fish. Okay, take him easy. Yeah, that jump should have taken it out of him a bit. Whoa, stay on. All right, I like that one.
Yeah, he's taking it on.
There we go.
Good start.
That's a good start. Oh, yeah, it's got some good weight. That'll do probably 1 3/4 pounds. Nice fish.
Captain America. Look at him, he's barely
yeah.
on the side of his back.
Yeah. Whoa. Don't lose him. Oh, good job.
All right.
Good job, man.
Good start.
That's a good start. Good choice on lures.
Yeah. This is called the Captain America. Got the name because red, white, and blue. Gets a lot of action, and when it's coupled with this UV sling blade, and particularly in this water, early morning, just a dynamite lure. We're gonna go about 15 feet. That's where we got that last fish. And right now we're running in about 26 feet of water. So I'm getting in that mid range. As the sun comes up, we'll start dropping them down a little bit deeper. But right now we're gonna be running right around 15, 16 feet.
It's good to keep those fish submerged in cold water, icy water. They won't lose any weight that way.
We try and keep these humdingers and crip lures when we're trolling them about between 1.6 and 1.8 miles an hour, and we were down to about 1.4, so I bumped it up, and right after I bumped up the speed is when we caught that fish.
Oh, it's going down too, bud. Get that little one out of the way. Yeah, this feels like a decent fish. Ready?
Fishing in the same area is the team of Dave Pitts, Curtis Palmer, and Jeff Fitter. You've had an excellent weight the first day and are using a wide range of tackle, including using two sling blades in tandem, which gives your bait more action.
We'll drop her down just a little bit here, put her underneath the water, and let that current dictate that. Got a little bit of a max blade on the back wedding ring, tipped with a crawler, but you got these Shasta tackle blades. And actually, the leader could be just a slightly bit shorter to really whip that back. There we go, it's starting to get there. And then what we'll do is we'll just send that rascal down. And we got one fishing down 5 feet off the bottom, and we're gonna put this one on a shuttle hawk, and we're gonna send her down to a midwater column here and try to pick up some fish. We've been doing pretty good on some of the larger fish. There we go. Especially with the turbidity of the water, these UV blades are really working well along with these Macs. So what we'll do is we'll take this and I like running it out my top one longer. A lot of guys do the reverse, but I'm finding it running it out back further away from the boat, the top one, that we've been picking up more fish today by doing this. Well, with a tandem sling blade that I have down there, we're running max smile blades and wedding rings. I also like to re-thread them with P-line. My choice is either 8-pound, 10, or 12, depending on what we're fishing for, Kokanee Max or just regular rainbows. But the Max Smile Blades put off a lot of flash down there. It's works real well. I have very good success with it and haven't lost anything yet. No line failure at all with P-line. But it's a good combination, sling blades and Mac lures, good combination. We've been finding between 30 and 40 feet that the fish are all kind of in a, they must be in a thermocline down there between 25 and 35 feet. There's like a 10-foot spacing there that we've been picking up some fish consistently. But also we've been pulling at about 1.5 to 1.9 miles an hour.
On,
here we go,
on.
Fish on right here. Want him, Jeff?
No, go for it.
All right.
We'll
go ahead and
back her off.
We'll kick her off.
I'll net over the back.
All righty.
Actually, I got a good flash there.
Yeah.
It's a little
fish. It might be a little small fish here, but
it is.
Came deep, but we're in that water column. They're coming up. So
let's kick it.
You want to release it?
Yeah.
All righty. Just tackle UV.
It's been a beautiful weekend on Diamond Lake for a trout derby, and now as the morning turns to afternoon, the wind's starting to pick up and the bite's getting even better.
Hey, what, that Max Smile Blade kind of...
That little gold one is... that little gold one, we're coming down through a lot of these small guys. Hold steady, little guy.
I'm marking...
They're hungry, though, with this wind chop. Still, look how fat these guys are. They're just a really fat little bit. Oh, sorry, bud. That right there is the smile blade that we just caught that little trout on. So, a couple green blade beads and a little gold smile blade worked good. Tip with a night crawler.
Man.
Sitting here and... Yes.
Garden hack.
Slide that on the hook just a little bit like that. Up there and just try to keep that so the nightcrawler lays straight in the water.
From out here in Diamond Lake, when you're trolling around, there's lots of peaks and ridges that you can look at. For instance, behind me here is Mount Thielson, and it has very nice trail. A lot of people go up there on top of the vista, and there's a little time capsule on the top up there where people can leave notes and dates when they hike the peak. On the other side of the lake, across from the lodge here, is Bailey, Mount Bailey, and it is open to snowcat skiing and I believe still helicopter. So up there on the north side is Diamond Peak, and as it goes that Trapper was up there on Diamond Peak, and when he looked down from his horse down here onto Diamond Lake, it looked, or I should say looked down on the lake, it looked like a bunch of shimmering diamonds. Therefore the name has come Diamond Lake. As we look down to the south down there, you can see a high peak up there, and that's going to be the rim to Crater Lake, one of the 10 wonders of the world.
Well, things have changed quite a bit from yesterday to today. It's
fish.
An entirely
little
different...
Guy.
Oh, another fish on. There we go. Good job.
Little guy. And he's flat and he's very big. Let me walk this way and you get it for me.
Today is a totally different fishery than yesterday.
Well,
today we're dealing with a lot more wind, which is actually, it couldn't be a benefit at times because of the additional wind chop, which could be a diffused light situation, especially with the green turbidity of the water, to where we're definitely bringing these fish into the mid-water column, bringing them up off the bottom a little more is what we're finding, but it's also making it hard to tack a good course to where you can actually stay on the same line that you were successful on yesterday. It's a little chillier today. I think I'm my worst enemy. I keep thinking to myself, what would Gary Miralles be doing right now?
That's two fish in a hurry. This one's not as big as the last one. We just switched over a minute ago and put on a Captain America again. It's a
little guy.
Yeah, it's a little guy.
and got our biggest fish in the morning. We picked up a 16 incher on that. That UV red still been producing. That was a hot lure for us yesterday. We're still getting them today. We got some real rough conditions right now. The weather is obviously changing. We got a front coming in and it's creating some pretty good winds here. But the bite seems to be coming on right now. Well, it's a two fish limit out here today, and these are our two biggest fish right now. We're a little under the size we had yesterday, but we were in seventh place, and this, with the rougher conditions today, it should maintain at least our position there. But we still need to get some bigger fish if we can.
At the end of the day, no matter what size your fish are, Shelter Cove Resort's a nice place to be, and taking first place in the junior division was Brandon George. While some local knowledge and some good old-fashioned bait fishing techniques helped Steve Husted and Randy Webb take the $1,000 first place prize. Hey, thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.